Good afternoon, everybody. It's Tuesday, which means it's time for our family support Q&A. I think it's going to be a really good one today. This is an important topic for so many people. We're going to be talking to Nicholas Love from the World Institute on Disability. He's coming all the way from California to talk to you about your benefits, how to make money, get a job, and protect your benefits and really build financial capacity. So we're really excited about that. So without further ado, let's introduce Nicholas Love. Thanks for joining us today, Nicholas.
Thank you. So my name is Nicholas Love. I work at the World Institute on Disability. I am the Director of Community Inclusion there. And today we're going to talk about one of our tools, which is Disability Benefits 101. And Missouri is very blessed to be one of the 10 states that have DB 101. And it is an online tool that they will to help you work through the myths and confusion about Social Security, employment, healthcare benefits, and more. Now, before I get into this, I'm gonna back up one little slide. We have a disclaimer. I'm not gonna be able to answer any personal specific information, but I will give you access to that individual help and resources. And almost any question you're gonna have, I'm probably gonna direct you right back to Missouri DB 101 because it is full of a lot of information. So most of the time you can get your information when you want it right away, because DB 101 is there providing 24/7, 365 accurate information. I know there's a lot of misinformation out there. We wanna make sure you get the accurate information when you need it. There is no need to be an expert or even find an expert. You have the same information everyone else has. So you don't have to be connected to a system. When it's 2 a.m. and you have a nagging question, you get that answer. There is no personal identifying information. So it's a safe harbor. It's a place to try out information without any bells going off at Social Security that someone's looking at employment. It's there to understand how your benefits can be impacted when going to work. And there are very easy to use estimators. I'm going to show you a couple of those results that you can use to put in your information to get the information you want. There's also incredible short little videos about SSI and SSDI that'll help you go to work, help you understand it. And there's also access to local, state, and national resources. So Missouri DB 101 is Missouri specific. So it's very, very helpful. Yes, I'm in California, but this is about Missouri. So the website, which is just missouri.db101.org. So this is your site. This is the Missouri DB 101. Very easy to use, very user-friendly. It is available on any device. It is not mobile responsive, which means, yes, you can use it on your phone, but it might be a little chunky. But it's there for you. You are able to work through myths, learn about building your assets, learn about job supports, work incentives, which are the rules that Social Security created to help you go to work. Most people think Social Security says you can't go to work without disability. Well, they actually made rules to support you going to work, and we're going to talk about that. There's a section about young people, about their benefits, getting a higher education, and if somebody is new to disabilities, maybe some of the resources that can help them if they're newly required disability. Programs covered are SSI, Supplemental Security Income, that supplements the income people don't have for food and shelter. And then Social Security Disability Insurance, SSDI, which is a social insurance that you're paying in through your FICA taxes. It's actually your premium, your FICA is your premium. And then we have a great tool about finding healthcare coverage for you and how health benefits work. There are two main estimators, which I'm going to show you in a second. And there's also, if I go to the top, a video tab. And this is a video tab that we'll have short videos on. What is SSI and SSI and work, et cetera. And we'll come back to that in a moment too. I want to start by bringing you into the SSI programs. And I'm going to bring you here first because I'm going to tell you that everything's set up pretty much the same way. Everything starts with the basics. So they'll be able to provide you an overview of what it is. And anytime there's a program mentioned, they're going to tell you eligibility and how to apply. So you can even use DB 101 to apply for benefits. Now, the majority of people who apply for benefits, because they're not organized, that's why they get their refusal. or the denial process. So getting that information up front is really helpful and understanding that decision. What is a disability according to Social Security? What are the resources and income limits for SSI? How is that income counted? And then SSI and work. And that's what we want to focus on today is what about going to work? So if I click into the article SSI and work, I'm going to learn about some of those rules that I talked about. How the rules actually mean that your benefits won't go down as much as your earnings go up. So basically for every $2 you earn, you get to keep a dollar of your check. And then they go into all these rules about impaired work expenses, things you're paying out of your pocket to go to work can actually be not counted as income. And if you're under age 22 and going to school, nothing is going to affect your benefits. So we're going to talk about that. And we'll talk about ABLE accounts, past plans, ticket to work program. So a lot of this information is right there for you. I'm going to start, I'm still in the SSI and work section. I'm going to what's called our mini estimator. And our mini estimator, you can click in and you can enter some basic information. And this kind of gives you a snapshot of how the other estimators work as well. So you can go in and say somebody gets the full benefit rate of 841. That is the maximum someone can receive in SSI benefits. No other supplemental benefits because they're blind. Blind is the only disability that has special rules. They're not under age of 22, but if they were, we could talk about that, but I'm going to show you a different estimator for that. And no work in the last couple months. And if they had work, those areas, yes, but on gray. We can easily go in and create a job about gross income. So hourly wages, let's say it's minimum wage. Let's start. Now we want people to earn as much money as they need. And people always ask, how much money can make on benefits? The answer is, how much do you need? Think about what you need in your life and then find those supports to go with it. So what we're going to start with a baseline of minimum wage at 20 hours, just to show you how to start, right? So at 970 gross, use those, show my results. So what you have is a quick snapshot. In this snapshot, you have more income. And that's what people want to know, three things basically, right? You want to know, are you going to be better off? How much money will you have? And will you have your health care? And DB101 answers those three questions for you in a couple clicks. We're able to show that the full benefit rate of 841. And then if this person goes to work, again, this is just minimum wage, 20 hours, we're able to show that they have earnings of $970 and they still have their benefit check, which was reduced to $398. So that's for every $2 you earn, you get to keep one, which means you went from 841 to 1,368. That is significant more income. It's actually $527 more, it says. And if we go up here, you'll be eligible for Missouri Health Net without a spend out. So that's your Medicaid. So you get to keep your health care, you get still have a benefit check coming in, and you have more money. A very quick snapshot. We also talk about other ways to connect to benefit planning to allow individuals. So it'll connect you to the work incentive planning and assistance. We can also talk about Missouri Health Net, food stamps, and temporary assistance. So all that information is right there for you. So that's a quick snapshot. Now, if I went through and I did a full DB101 session, I could get a snapshot like this. That talks about, we ask more questions when we do the estimators. I'll show you where they are in a moment. But this shows somebody who is on SSI and SSDI going to work, earning $14.30. I have this person working at Target, which is what the average is in Missouri, which we just said minimum wage was $11.15. Target, $14.30. So this individual, we're able to show their cash cliff. This is with their SSDI. Stops, they're working full-time, but see how much more money they still have. We're able to show they went from their benefits being available now of $1,000 to $2,000. So an incredible increase in income. And as well, we're able to show the healthcare, not only does it stay, but they're getting healthcare through their employer, so they actually have more healthcare options. So they're able to have their Medicare and their Medicaid, as well as private insurance through their employer. So going to work doesn't reduce your benefits and healthcare. It actually increased it for this person. You're able to learn.
Plus, you've got some fan clubs with the calculator. I think it's so cool to be able to play with the numbers and see that. And I'm just going to reiterate what you were showing us in the first graph. You are going to lose some of your benefits money, but that money is going to be more than replaced by your earnings. And I think that's the important thing. And I really like that you said it's how much you have in your pocket at the end of the day that makes sense. So yes. I think that's really cool. We do have a question asking about if there's a chat feature on this website. So if you're on here, if you can get any assistance.
There is not a chat feature, but we do connect you back to benefit planners to be able to help you with more information. I want to show one other thing while I'm in this graph. To be able to explain that, why does this dip down? I could simply go to the timeline, and this is what's incredible. It shows any significant change throughout the time period. So you can just read through it. I'm back on the homepage, and where the estimators are in this little orange box down here. So you have your benefit and work estimator, which is for anybody over the age of 18 on SSI or SSDI. You have your school and work estimator, though, for people under the age of 18 on SSI going to school. So you can go in and answer a couple questions for them, considerably less even. And this is what you get. In this plan, you're better off. Exclamation mark, all excitement, right? And if an individual youth is getting benefits, it's because of low income and resources of the parents. And so let's say this individual was receiving $250 of benefits, and then they want to go to work 10 hours, minimum wage, a very simple job to start getting that work experience. But parents are a little concerned about losing that check and that health care. Doing the school and work estimator, we're able to show that their $250 of their benefits remains, and they don't lose a penny because what's called student earned income exclusion, which says that if long as you're under age 22 and going to school at least half time, you can get your benefits and not a penny. Doesn't affect anything. So they went from benefits of $250 that the parents might have been very concerned about losing to bringing $735 into the home and is already starting to get those work experience, and they're paying FICA, which means they're paying into their SSDI, which means they may be eligible for SSDI later in life. We're able to show that healthcare coverage continues, and we're able to show that income changes. And again, you can compare these, you can make a new one. You can compare like, okay, maybe I want to get a job making more than minimum wage. Wonderful, whatever works for you. And I will talk you through the whole process. You can compare them and connect to the benefit planners. You can make a file out of it and share it with, say, your case manager, your teachers, saying, yes, I am going to work and this is my plan. You can email it to someone. It's all yours to be able to support. Now I'm going back to the homepage, and I showed you SSI. Well, the SSDI set up exactly the same way, how to apply, reporting your wages, all that. SSDI work also has a little quick tool, or you can utilize the full estimators again, school and work, benefit work. And you notice that's a different spot where I clicked before, because we want to make sure you're never going to be lost. You're going to find what you need and not have to remember five clicks back, I saw what I wanted. And if you ever get lost, you can simply put in the search bar what you're looking for. Now, the other things we talk about is finding the right healthcare coverage for you, which is great. You can go into finding the right healthcare coverage for you, and you can put in, say your family income is 40,000. Let's say you have three people in your family and your resources. And if you don't know what that means, you can always click on any of our definitions that explain resources less than $5,035. No one in the family has health care coverage, but there's children in the family. Let's say grandma's there and she's on Medicare And let's say the child has a disability as well. Grandma's over 65. Simple questions. See my options. These are all the healthcare options in Missouri available to you. You can go down a little further and learn each about each one of these. But you notice it even puts in the resource limit for that house of three. And if you want to know more about it, say you want to know more about disability-based income, click, you're right in the article that tells you all about it.
I've always used this site for people with disabilities, but in working with families, what a great tool that is for the medical insurance. I've never thought about using this. Thank you.
You're welcome. We also then have the article, how health benefits work. So you can talk about income-based Missouri health net. So that would be maybe for people without disabilities. And then you have disability-based, and those are different. Your Medicare, your ticket to work programs, employer-sponsored, and even how to connect to healthcare.gov so everybody can utilize it to get the healthcare they need.
Nicholas, if somebody's got SSI and SSDI, does that is that of something that has to be considered in the calculator?
Yeah, so somebody has SSI and SSDI, you want to use the benefit work estimator. And that's the one I showed the quick little draft that went down. And this will explain who it's for, which is great. If it's not for you, they'll tell you, right? There is no identifying information. And you just had your Medicaid expansion. And throughout, we talk about how to get more information about Medicaid expansion in Missouri. Since it's new, we want to make sure people have that information. So throughout, there's a little notes that you'll find. So you can go through there and you can learn about your SSI, your SSDI. It'll ask you your benefits. You want to make sure you have the accurate information to put in, because wrong information in, wrong information out. But you can cover SSI, SSDI, childhood disability benefit, the supplemental aid for the blind in Missouri, blind pension, food stamps, talking about housing and earned income disregard. So if, say, you're on Section 8, learning about Missouri Health Net, Missouri Ticket to Work, which will help with getting people to work and maintaining Medicare, employer-sponsored, individual health care, and earned income tax credits are all discussed. So you simply answer a couple questions and you'll get the information about how your SSI and your SSDI can go together. That is some of the programs, but we have additional information as well. We have the information about young people. So we have benefits for young people, which will talk about why benefits matter, the key programs, the eligibility of the programs, specific eligibility for SSI, your health net, Medicaid, private healthcare, all those programs that can support young people and their benefits. We also have an article on getting a higher education, which is wonderful for everyone, youth or not, as somebody who got a degree much later in life. You can learn about pursuing your health, your education. You can learn about the application process. So they'll talk you through that process. Funding your education, maybe where to get a scholarship, how to fill out a Pell Grant, getting a job while working, utilizing the Disability Rights Resource Center at a university, college, or school. What are the rights for students and other financial considerations, all covered. So that's really great to help people choose where to go to school, learn about things in school, and be able to move forward. So here we have the high school equivalency we talk about in Missouri, and it goes deeper and deeper into other aspects of education. Back on our homepage, we have articles about going to work specifically. So we have getting past the myth, building your assets and wealth, job supports, and work incentives. So getting past the myth, one of my favorite places, because it has all the myths that everybody's told you why they can't go to work. There's like seven major ones. And so we pulled them out. And so like one of them may be, I'm afraid of losing my healthcare. So the myth is, if I work, I'll lose my healthcare. I click in there. We have a little box that kind of pulls out what people may say, saying that they have ongoing healthcare needs they would never be able to pay for themselves. And people tell them they shouldn't go to work because they're not going to see their doctor and get their care. Because everybody's got an opinion about what you shouldn't do. Trust the experts. right? So we go down a little bit further and we talk about losing your healthcare can be a huge concern if you're thinking about going to work. However, several programs can help you keep your benefits. And then they break it down. What is Medicare, Medicare at Work, Missouri Health Net? So it's the same information within the health section, but condensed. So it's not a lot of reading. And it'll be able to direct you through that. Again, here's benefit people. You can learn more about it by going to the healthcare article. So if I click there, I'm back to my healthcare article that will give me more in-depth information. So when I'm back on the homepage and I go to work incentives, those are those rules that help people go to work. So I can learn about the SSDI work incentives. All the information that's very complex, but then it'll direct me to learning more and going into those rules. So there is ways that it interchanges and connects to each other so that you're not poking around a website trying to figure out where you're at. That's always so frustrating. So other myths can talk about what if your benefits stop? How do you get them back on again? So we talk about what's called expedited reinstatement. These are things you don't have to remember what I'm talking about. You just click the myth questions. It's really helpful to get those common myths taken care of. Building your wealth, assets, and wealth is important. One of the things I want to point out here, we talk about why it's important, but I want to point out ABLE accounts. ABLE accounts, when people are in SSI, or on other means-tested programs, which means they're based on their financial need, they usually have to keep low resources. So one of the things when you're on SSI, you can't have resources over $2,000. Well, that doesn't allow you to move forward in life when you can't save for life. So an ABLE account allows individuals to save at least $100,000 in a tax-exempt savings account that does not impact any benefits. SSI, Medicaid, housing, nothing's affected. So ABLE accounts are really helpful. And you can learn about saving up to $100,000, the contributions you can pay, how to open an account. It'll even directly direct you to Missouri's ABLE account themselves, but you can also shop to other states. And other states have different resource limit, different rules. Find the one that works for you, right? Talks about your disability qualifications, comparing the rules for depositing money, which are wonderful because right now they just upped it. It's $16,000 a year up to that $100,000. And if you go to work, you can contribute more work income of up to $12,880. So really, really helpful. And how you can use an ABLE account right alongside a special needs trust. So a special needs trust, the individual doesn't have access to their account. It's somebody else manages it. An ABLE account is managed by the individual. And if that is something that concerns people, you can always have a trust fund feed into an ABLE account. So the ABLE account doesn't have the $100,000 in it. And it can go back and forth that way. So it's really great. Here's that additional money you can put in. I'm going to work. So ABLE accounts, really, really helpful. Another is learning about past plans, which is another way to save money for an education or vocational goal. And you can use that for even setting aside money for adaptive technology or assisted technology to help people move forward. Get those job supports, right? Find the job you want, find the job that feeds your heart, and then find the resources and supports to keep it going. So one of the ways you could find those supports is through the job support and accommodation article. It talks about the Americans with Disability Act. It talks about disclosing your disability.
So I hope those of you that are watching will go back and really spend some time thinking about how this can apply to your life today, but revisit it because there's always going to be new situations happening.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you, Sharon. So, information about disclosing your disability, when to disclose, how does this close, what are reasonable accommodations, how do you request those accommodations with the employer. Most people are concerned about requesting accommodations because they think it's going to turn the employer out. off. Most accommodations cost under $500 for the employer, and sometimes they're completely free. So you can even go and learn about common types of accommodations, right? What is some assistive technology that can help you? Where to go to even try out assistive technology in Missouri, and how to get it funded. So we're not going to say, hey, you can go get technology somewhere, good luck. We're going to direct you to, so how you could use your pass plan for that technology. You could use a pass plan to start your own business. I always forget to mention that. It's very important. But we can connect you to all those resources. Learn about closing that gap. So personal care assistance, how to do it. What about workplace personal assistance services? So all of that's in there under job supports and accommodations. We even talk about the interactive process of asking for disabilities. So what do you do? Step one, two, three, et cetera, right? So we get you through that whole entire discussion. One of the things is every single section starts with the basics, but always ends with next steps. And next steps will get you to additional resources, like the Job Accommodation Network, where you can get a list of common accommodations. So you can go and say, this is my disability. And what are some of the common accommodations for that disability? And which ones do I have to pay for? And if I have to pay for them, is there somebody that can help me? And if I have to pay for it, maybe it's an impairment related work expense. Again, those are the rules that help you earn more money. So we can talk you through that process. So very, very helpful. We go down, ticket to work. Here again is your benefit planners, right? So throughout, you can find the information you need. One of the things that I think is wonderful is the videos. So Missouri has elected to have several little videos. And these videos are just cute as heck. They have, what is SSI? So explaining what is SSI. Explain what happens if you go to work. But I just talked about how you can get your Medicaid and keep it and all that. That's going to be in a little video to explain it to you. What if you're a young person, right? Student earned income exclusion, which is that little SEIE that I talked about. Here's a video on it. What about SSDI? And what if you're going to work on SSDI? And then work incentives in general. And these are all updated on an annual basis. You can see them underneath the video tab, but you can also, when I go into SSI, if I go down, there's the video again for that particular session. So again, things are interactive and interlaced.
We've had a number of people just talk about how informative this is. And I just wanna call out Stacy and the Missouri Developmental Disability Council, who are the organization that funds this website. And I think it's so nice to have these resources available across the state.
So you can go through again, go into SSI or SSDI, depending on which one you have. SSI supplements the income you don't have for food and shelter. People with low or no work history. SSDI is for those who have worked and paid into the social insurance policy through your FICA. And you can learn more about that. You can learn about SSI and SSDI. You can learn about applying for all of them. You have your quick estimators as well as your full estimator sessions you can do for school and work for youth. All of that's in there. Healthcare coverage. Still carrying on from what I talked about earlier, learned about, this is what we covered. And these were the results of those, find that healthcare coverage for you are also listed on the side because it's following me. We have examples, frequently asked questions. So you can even go in and find out what are some of them frequently asked questions. Because if you have the questions, somebody else did too. How to apply. So right here, how to apply, it'll take you right to that application. You have the application process on DB101. So you can apply directly, start your application online, have the phone numbers for everybody there. Here is getting your application ready. Remember, I talked about people not having all the information they need. This is the information you need. And I'm going to give you one last thing is Social Security. Does not train their people on work incentives, rules to help people go to work. It's just a fact. It's not a criticism. So if you want this information, DB101 is the place to get it. And if you are getting conflicting information from Social Security, you could use DB101 to bring the information forward to those Social Security workers to help them understand. One of the things I've worked with people in the past who weren't getting student earned income exclusion, they were taking 2-for-1 reduction. They were able to show a DB101 page going, this is what I'm supposed to happen. And they go, we're sorry. And they gave them back pay. So you can use DB101 as your expert. You don't have to go be an expert or go find it. It's your expert for you. And it's specifically for Missouri. I just really encourage you to try it again and again. Share it. Share it with your case manager if you have one, people that you're working with in vocational rehab. Let them know, I went to DB101 and I know I can go to work and this is what's going to happen to my benefits. And as an advocate and a person with a disability myself, I want you to dream. I don't want you to limit who you are based on fear of not getting what you need in life. Focus on your dream and then use DB101 to find those supports and information that supports that dream to allow you to accomplish whatever you choose in your life or your loved one's life, because no one should be limited simply because of our disabilities. So use DB101 to really get that message out and get rid of those myths so we can get people to work, so people can move out of poverty and live full lives as they choose.